For the next 2 weeks, I'm going to be doing a road trip through the Canadian Rockies, starting in Vancouver and finishing in Calgary.
This is without doubt the most incredible road I've ever driven on. It's just breathtaking.
Even though I'm technically going by myself, the plan is to meet up and travel with various backpacking friends I made on my round the world trip.
Just caught up with Brian, who I met in Bali, right here.
We went down the wrong road for like an hour?
I'm friends with Karl, I've known him for a few years.
Yeah, we just ended up putting up our tents and then some awesome random people just camped next to us.
You shall not pass!
Then finally in Calgary, I'll be staying with my brother and his family who've been living out there for the year.
So we're just about to do the mountain biking. I might get stabilizers, yeah.
Loving it, saw some bears on the way down.
Tomorrow we're doing a zip line. It's over a kilometer long. 600 feet up, we're gonna go over 100 kilometers an hour. It's gonna be so much fun.
So normally I do this preamble at the airport, but since I'm traveling by myself this time, I don't wanna be sitting in the airport holding the camera doing a selfie introduction because I'd look like a complete dick. So instead, I'm doing it from the safety of my own apartment where I'm sure you'll still say I look like a complete dick, but anyway. So the reason I'm doing this trip to Canada is because my brother's been living out in Calgary for the year, and this is the first opportunity I've actually had to go out and see them. But instead of just flying into Calgary and then maybe popping to the Rockies, I'm flying into Vancouver and doing a 2 week road trip that's going to finish in Calgary. From Vancouver, I'll be taking the ferry to Victoria and spending the next 2 days exploring Vancouver Island. Then I'll head back to the mainland and up into the mountains for 3 action-packed days in Whistler. Following this, I'm going to catch up with some friends in Kelowna before making the long drive to the small town of Jasper in the Rockies. I'll have 3 nights here, followed by 3 nights in Banff, before finally finishing up the trip in Calgary.
So I used to film all my trips with this Sony Handycam, but I've now got this new Sony A7S camera, and I've barely even touched this thing yet, so I'm going to kind of use the Canada trip just to learn how to use the camera. So hopefully over the course of the trip, you'll notice the camera work improve, I hope. But I've also now got GoPro Hero 4 for all my action stuff. And then as a backup, I also have this Canon PowerShot D30, which is waterproof. And then if I'm feeling really lazy, I can just use my iPhone.
As soon as I booked this trip and put it on Facebook, all the Canadians I met backpacking on my round the world trip, they all got in touch. And hopefully I'm gonna meet up with lots of them at every stop along the way. So yeah, there's lots to look forward to. Flying out to Vancouver, I immediately met up with my mate Simon, who I'll be travelling with for the first week, and a few of his English travelling friends join us for a drink.
Welcome to Canada, we're in Vancouver at the moment. I'm friends with Karl, I've known him for a few years.
I met Simon in Chiang Mai in Thailand. If you saw the Thailand episode, which of course you did, Simon was in it for a good 60 seconds.
I was famous.
For the hair clipping.
I encouraged the whole hostel to shave a man's head. I orchestrated that.
Free Willy wants to get his flippers on the clippers.
Come to Canada to meet lots of nice Canadians, which is why I'm hanging out with like 6 English people.
Where are you from, Mark?
From Manchester.
Yorkshire.
English people stick together, as you can see.
We're just going to do the usual English thing, get a bit rowdy and smash the place up. It's actually quite surreal being back in Vancouver because back in 2003 I spent the summer in Vancouver. It was the end of my first year of uni and me and my mate were going to get jobs out here for 3 months over.
Is this
the summer.
Your mate James or another one?
No, it's not James. I got another mate. Yeah, me and my mate Adam got work visas and it was all planned to work out the entire summer. Instead of looking for jobs, we just basically got drunk and just bummed around in the bars. So it's quite surreal being back because suddenly you've got these memories flooding back in. I recognise bars, I recognise shops and different things.
We're starting first day of 2 weeks travelling around BC and Alberta. Probably see some wildlife, meet some cool Canadians, probably a few Australians as well because there's too many of them around here. But basically having an awesome time.
Whilst we're in Vancouver, we decided to stretch our muscles by walking up Grouse Mountain. It's only a 3 kilometer walk, but within that distance, you ascend 850 meters.
So doing the Grouse Grind at the top of Grouse Mountain. It's just a long slog, or a grind if you will. Just constant stairs going on and on.
All you're doing is staring at the step in front of you. You're not really looking through the forest or anything.
And the only sign you're making progress is there's a quarter mark sign and a half mark sign.
So it's a pretty intense hike. There better be a decent view at the top, let's hope so.
Yeah. It took us an hour and 10 minutes. It's supposed to take 90.
winning.
Before we pat ourselves on the back too much though, the record for a marathon runner doing the grind is under 24 minutes. But once we got our breath back, we went to see the two grizzly bears they have in captivity here.
Beautiful. Scratching his balls.
This guy here is Kula. Kula Kula. Oh. This guy is Grinder. He's from Invermere in the interior of the province.
These two grizzly bears are orphans that were rescued in 2001. Unfortunately, once a bear has been raised in captivity, it cannot be released into the wild as it simply won't survive. We're hoping to see some bears in the wild ourselves later in the trip, but first we're heading to Victoria to start our two-day journey around Vancouver Island.
So, where are we going, Simon?
We're off to Victoria, mate.
Should be good fun, and like Simon was saying, looking forward to hopefully weaving in and out of these islands. Maybe spot some wildlife along the way.
Road trip. What up?
Yeah, we just landed. Just arrived on Vancouver Island.
Checked in, have we?
Checked in. What is it like? Made birth? Yeah, we just made birth on Vancouver Island.
That's gonna be pretty sweet.
We were saying that this could almost be a country in itself. Although it's the capital of British Columbia, lots of people don't visit it. It's kind of bolted on the side, so it's definitely an interesting experience. It's just like Chiang Mai, where everything's just much more expensive. I might have to buy that. I have no choice but to part with $20.
That's awesome.
Unless you want to sell it for
$15. No, I'm good.
Haggling already, bloody hell.
Bye, guys.
We've both been told off for taking photos.
No pictures,
oh, sorry.
Please. Thank you.
It's a very secret market. Everybody started watching all the rhythm in a fishing rock and roll ruby. Rock and roll, rock and roll ruby. First impressions, I'm loving Victoria.
Yeah.
Lovely little market.
This is supposed to be the narrowest road in Canada. I don't know how it's a road or a narrow street. It's an alleyway, you know? It's like, how is this a street? This is an alleyway.
You couldn't fit a car down here. You couldn't fit someone who's a bit obese down here.
But Karl can just about squeeze in.
Just through it, just yeah.
It's
yeah.
Tight.
Just breathe in, breathe in. Yeah. Pretty cool though.
Just stumbled upon like a marching band competition, and it's pretty awesome actually. Like, they're really good.
3, 2, 3!
What's going on here?
All right, so we are Shorecrest High School. We're a Scottish doing school. This is our marching band. I think it's really cool. We have bagpipes, which is something unique.
I love bagpipes, yeah.
Yeah, and we're marching in the parade tomorrow, so.
Cool.
We were just saying how much culture Victoria had. It just keeps taking it up a level.
Yeah.
You've been here an hour and a half.
We're just outside of Victoria at Peyto Lake. Today we're driving to Tofino, so it's going to be about 4 or 5 hours of driving.
What you got here, Simon?
Welcome to Canada. Canadian maple leaf symbol. I've just picked it off this massive tree, which is like 100 metres high. If I could keep that and take it with me, I would, but I've got a feeling it'll get damaged. But for now, we'll just have a little symbol for the next few minutes.
This is Canada.
Of how awesome Canadian trees are and their size.
It's going to be a good day, I think. The campsite we were supposed to be staying at, we just found actually shut until next month, so we've got to find another campsite at the end of the night, but we've got some marshmallows and stuff, so we're pretty good to go.
I thought I'd done well.
That's Simon's leaf right here. Okay.
I appreciate them both more than you, Karl.
I win. This is Canada right here. Right here.
Even though we had a 5-hour drive to Tofino, there was plenty of places to stop along the way.
So we kind of need some facts about this town, but we don't have any for you right now, so Karl's going to do a voiceover later on.
Yeah, pretty much.
Tumanus was founded as a logging town in 1858, but with the decline of the industry in the 1980s, they decided to rejuvenate the town with these large murals. The first 5 were painted in 1982, and there are now 44, transforming the centre into an outdoor art gallery.
It's like you get to one and you look around, you see another one.
Yeah.
Go check that out and we'll get over there and we'll find another one over there.
Detail on that's pretty amazing. Loving the nature.
Definitely, I've got a smile on my face. It's a bit creepy, isn't it?
Simon, you have a big thing for trees, then?
I have a big obsession with trees. Just love the feeling of walking through trees and kind of just being at one with nature. I've always been out running in trees since I was a little kid.
What do you think of the trees so far in Vancouver?
I'm very impressed with the quality of the tree on Vancouver Island. I'd probably give it a solid 8.4 out of 10 so far, but I haven't really got up close and personal yet, so it might get kinky and I'll bump it up another point.
A kinky with a squirrel hole or something.
That'd be bigger than a squirrel hole, mate.
Whatever.
We're now at Cathedral Grove, which has some trees that are 800 years old, and they're pretty damn big, so.
How are you feeling, Simon?
I'm pretty good, man. I think I'm in my element. It's nice to meet trees that are almost as wise as I am.
Nearly as old as well.
Just like the waterfalls, this is completely exceeding expectations. It's absolutely gorgeous.
These are probably like the oldest living things you're ever gonna be like next to.
It's pretty good.
Yeah. And you got old trees sort of falling over on the ground, and you've got the one still standing and all the greenery just covering it, and it's just so full of colour and life. It's gorgeous.
The best thing is, it's free!
It is free. It's a very, very good point. Give us some loving, Simon.
Alright, my turn.
Yeah, kiss. Give it a kiss.
That's just getting a bit weird, Karl. It's over 800 years old, 76 metres tall, 9 metres round.
After a long day of driving, we arrived in Tofino, and with a little help from the tourist info, we found an alternate campsite to stay at.
All right, this is our campsite for the night, and we're gonna have people camping beside us, so hopefully they're sound, and if not, we'll just get drunk anyway. And then the best thing is, we're right on the beach.
Check that out.
Got beach volleyball if we so want.
Yeah, we just ended up putting up our tents and then some awesome random people just camp next to us.
Hi, I'm Katie.
Where are you from?
Well, originally from Michigan, but I'm living in Bend, Oregon now.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Kelly. I'm from Bend, Oregon.
And what's your name, Jaron?
My name's Jaron.
That's crazy.
And what's special about today?
That's my 30th birthday.
Woohoo!
Woohoo!
And cheers. You don't look a day over 29.
Hey, so. Thanks. Thanks,
plus
Carl.
One.
Thanks, Carl.
How'd you meet Katie?
Oh, I was on the side of a road and
he was hitchhiking.
I was like, hey, pretty lady, you're up for a good time.
You kind of have to talk to the cars more than the people, don't you? Come on, keep trying. So this is like the 30th birthday tree. And you
so
are
we break it?
You're enjoying yourself, clearly.
I'm so happy, as you can see.
And now we're out trying to find some firewood for them. We've already paid for ours, so it's almost like commercialism versus the free world. The free wood. Who can win?
What have you found?
Hey, look at that.
Evidence that there is an abundance of firewood in nature, okay?
Let's move the tents here, we can set the bridge on fire.
You shall not pass!
Wow, Aussie Gandalf.
Yeah, so...
G'day, Frodo!
So, just don't pass.
Come on, check this out, Carl.
Yeah.
What is it?
It's a sand dollar. Fossilized jellyfish. Wow! Jared, get one!
Not bad. I'll give you that.
That's good Kindle.
Do you want to cut some wood? We could actually have a wood off.
You can
just like slam it the best.
All right.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Did it.
Carl, the girls looked more competent than you.
Again, I get to edit the video, so it doesn't matter.
Fuck yeah.
How many takes, Jaron? Oh! Well, you grazed it,
Kate, can you show us what you're cooking there?
Oh, I'm making salmon with lemon.
Okay, Simon, what have we got to eat?
Sausages and
hot dogs. Buns.
We've got three full hot dogs and, like Simon says, the circumcised hot dog right
I'll
there.
I'll take the circumcised.
The Jewish one.
Oh yeah, you like the circumcised one.
Who wants the Jewish hot dog?
Yeah, the Jew dog. There you go again.
Jog. Jog on.
You alright, Katie? You enjoying your birthday?
Oh, you're I'm good? Loving this.
Yeah?
Yes. This place is magical.
Oh, sure.
Oh, you betcha.
So this is the end of our, what is it, the second full day, hanging out on a beach somewhere in Tofino.
We've left the campfire unattended, actually. It should be fine.
We've got a couple of propane tanks just right next to the fire. Right. And that's just standard, isn't it?
This feels like the holiday's really begun now. Like, we're basically in the middle of nowhere, right on the edge of Canada.
Yeah, it looks like Canada. It's a strange combination of tree and sand and water.
It's an amazing, beautiful place. I don't think many people really come here.
And I've never seen anything like it.
This is what traveling's all about. We're in a really beautiful place, hanging out with some people we've just met, and we're acting as if we've been friends all our lives. An amazing time. It's absolutely brilliant. So, can't ask for anything more than this.
I love you, Karl.
Namaste.
Shoni, you the best.
Should we call it a night then?
Well, oh, Karl, you used to see
Karl.
That.
We're not Australian.
Yeah, yeah.
Fucking to use that.
We'd had two fantastic days on Vancouver Island, and we're now heading back to the mainland and up into the mountains for three nights at Whistler, the popular ski resort just an hour north of Vancouver. In the summer, the ski slopes here transform to mountain bike tracks. Considering Whistler's known as one of the best places in the world for downhill mountain biking, we decided to give it a go for ourselves.
So we're just about to do the mountain biking. We've paid for a beginner's course because I'm a beginner. I did one day of it in Nepal, but that was just on like a shitty road rather than actual bike track, and I didn't really know what I was doing, so I took it nice and easy.
So we're doing like the beginner course because Karl is a beginner and he's going to slow me down, and I might ditch him later on and do some more hardcore shit that still won't be that hardcore. We've got a guide who's going to be taking us out.
So take me from my very beginning stages and then hopefully get my confidence up and be smashing it by the end. Should be good fun. I'm a little apprehensive because I don't really know what's going to happen, but it should be a good laugh.
Do you know what a bike is, Karl?
Well, I know what a bike is. I know how to ride a fucking bike. It's just a downhill bike
on a mountain. You can get stabilisers on these ones if you want.
I might get stabilisers, yeah.
I had to do my last run down. It's been going well so far. I don't want to celebrate how well it's been doing until I get to the bottom.
Yeah, right.
Had a great instructor here, Mike. Northern
for your help, dude.
From Darlington.
Yeah, so section like through the corners, it's getting twisted in, dropping down at the turn a little bit. Always looking where you're going.
Right, I want Mike to say like one more time what he said just then. On record, officially.
Oh yeah, definitely my best progressive rider for the season so far.
And it's been a long season so far. You've taught a lot of people.
Thousands.
Yeah,
but really good.
Yeah. Winning.
Spot on.
Nice one.
Yeah, man.
You were okay, Sam, and you were all right.
Yeah, I really enjoyed it.
Smashing it.
I just want to do a little bit more now.
Yeah. Simon's going to do a couple of runs. I'm going to go to the bar.
Yeah.
Nice one, Mike.
No worries. Cheers. Glad you enjoyed it, lad.
That was pretty epic. I have to say, I probably feel equally as good as the first time I did it. I saw some bears on the way down.
Hello, buddy.
Dude, I've seen like four bears today while doing downhill mountain biking. Some people have gone paid to try and see a bear. But yeah, absolutely awesome. Loved it. I'm definitely doing some more downhill mountain biking. Yeah. Quality day.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to do some in the future.
Buzzing off the mountain biking, we carried on drinking all evening, which left us hanging in the morning.
It's not a bad way to cure a hangover. Literally takes the breath out of your body. And my balls have just gone right back into my body, it's so cold.
There's this badass rope swing here. I'm standing on the platform and you literally get that, swing right off here and land probably where Karl is, but fuck. I mean, it's quite big.
My history of jumping off high things in the water.
Yeah, you're going to back out.
With our hangovers cured, we went for a walk through the woods. We'd had a tip from a friend that just south of Whistler, there was an old train wreck that had come off the rails and been left in the forest.
So this morning, we're trying to find the train wrecks that's just a little south of Whistler at a place called Function Junction. So this is not something most people do, but it's been pretty awesome so far. Seen some cool waterfalls. Simon's loving it.
Good start to the day. We haven't even found the train yet.
And we have it all to our... Oh, for fuck's sake. Now, going down this bit of the river feels definitely very hobbity. With some barrels, elves firing arrows.
After about an hour's walking, the train wreck finally appeared through the trees.
This is the train wreck site, so we're actually standing on top of the train right now. The train must have come off the tracks over there and sort of toppled down here. I don't know what kind of train it was. I mean, hoping it wasn't a passenger train. It doesn't look like a passenger train, probably a cargo one. The right train now. Track's probably about 20 meters over there, so it's had a hell of a fall. I mean, I think there was a big curve there and it must have been going around too fast or something.
Yeah, it's an S-bend, I think.
Yeah, hit a squirrel and just went all the way off. And since then, they've built like a bike park out of it. It's covered in graffiti. There's loud dogs in the background.
We're literally in the middle of a downhill bike course. I'd like to rip up that track, jump off the end there.
This is where they start.
I mean, the bike track's not really being used anymore because it's got holes in it and ramps are missing. But yeah, you literally climb up that ladder with a bike and then kick it off from there.
We should definitely go up.
I'm all right here. You know, I can see. Head's above level.
We'll climb the bikes up the ladder onto here, go down here and keep jumping over all the different wrecks. Doesn't look like it's been used in a long time, but... You're pretty sweet if you're into that sort of thing, which I'm not, but...
Looking around, we started to notice some holes in our theory about how the train came off the tracks.
There's the intelligent one here, the group, has asked the question, how did it get in here without knocking all my beloved trees down?
So as with any of life's problems, we turned to Google for the answer.
The crash occurred in 1956, shortly after a family moved to the area.
Apparently, it was going to cost them way too much to recover the trains, so they just left them here.
They just like jammed on the tracks, but then they couldn't move them, so they literally just dragged them down into the forest.
Ah.
Yeah.
Slightly less spectacular, really.
Yeah, because I was going to say, they should all be attached. They should like, you'd had to have neatly dragged them through the trees.
After a fantastic morning, it was time for our next big activity, the Superfly Zipline.
Tomorrow we booked a zipline. It's not just any zipline.
It's over 1 kilometre long, 600 feet up. We're going to go up 100 kilometres an hour.
I've never done a zipline before apart from in a playground. So I probably may shit myself, but also may have an amazing experience that I'll never forget.
It's going to be so much fun. I can't wait for that. It's just going to be pure, pure joy.
Thinking, buddy?
Slightly nervous. I've seen the massive valley we've got across, but it looks pretty epic, man.
How's this compared to the Thailand one?
It's just different to the
Thailand. Because the Thailand one, you're in the trees, are you? Here, yeah. Above them, right?
The Thailand one's very different to this. This is a lot higher up.
Here we go, Karl.
Oh, nice, mate. Let's do it. Sick.
It's actually quite relaxing.
Yeah.
It was just like you just feel free and just dangle away. It's nice.
Yeah, like you said, pretty relaxing.
When you actually look down, it's like, bloody hell, this is high up.
Yeah.
Really, really high, but it was awesome. Loved it. We've just done the highest one right there. That's like 600 feet high. And now we're going to do the longest one here, which is 1.3 kilometers.
Z2 riders left and right, ready and adjusted.
All right, mate.
Yeah.
See you on the other side.
Lift off.
See ya.
See ya. Shit, that's definitely quicker. Woo-hoo!
I'm coming after you.
Down there.
better draw? Oh, that was amazing. That was so fast.
That was definitely
so fast. Oh, that was epic. Like, stupidly fast.
Yeah, quick.
That was so good. So much fun. Zip line number three looks pretty steep.
But yeah, top speed of about 75 to 95 kilometers an hour in about 5 seconds.
Yeah. So. Can't film this one because it's too steep and too fast. So I'll see you on the other side. That one was super fast.
Super quick.
That was ridiculous.
Last one, buddy.
Yeah, man.
This is it.
This is what we've been training for.
In 3, 2, 1.
Go! Woo-hoo!
You like it, mate?
That was fun. That was some good, clean fun.
Good, clean fun.
Nice bit of adrenaline, not too intense.
Yeah.
Great. Really good.
I think mountain biking buzzed me up a little bit more.
Yeah. I mean, the mountain biking was more rewarding.
You were more, and it was more physical, where you're out of breath.
Yeah.
So there's that element to it, yeah.
I mean, the mountain biking was just so rewarding for me because I didn't fuck it up, basically. But this was just pure fun.
We're coming to the end of our 3 nights in Whistler, and we've had such a good time, even if it wasn't quite what we expected.
We were saying earlier that, you know, Whistler doesn't have the backpacking scene that we hoped it would. We're hoping it'd be like Queenstown. It is like Queenstown in terms of it's a beautiful place in the mountain and there's tons to do, but it's not a backpacking place.
No one's doing what I'm doing, which is just a few days passing through. And everyone in the hostel is actually just living here and working here.
We thought we were going to get to a hostel and be like a big bar and like loads of stuff going on every night, but however, I don't want to shit on the hostel. We're staying at Southside Lodge and it is a nice place and they're a startup place. They're trying to get it going. And it is the best place to stay in Whistler if you're a backpacker. And the best thing about it is just across the road is this place, Creek Bread, which has the best pizza we've ever had.
All organic produce. We've been here 2 nights in a row. My housemate recommended it. She just moved from Whistler to Kelowna and said, look, you have to come here.
The service here has been fantastic. Like, they've just cooked us up our own special menu for us.
The pizza you've prepared for us is your design.
Just to treat us, because we've been here 2 nights in a row, it's that good.
It's my last day travelling with Simon, and we have to make the long scenic drive to his new hometown of Kelowna.
That's the great thing about travelling from this part of the world. You can have these long drives, but there's always these beautiful things to stop at along the way. This is pretty impressive. It's the first stop of the day. Second stop of the day is Joffrey Lake. It's just the lower one. Pretty beautiful. Of course, whenever you hear the name Joffrey, you just think of that little shit from Game of Thrones, but nothing to do with that. It's a beautiful place.
Weren't expecting this drive to be so beautiful, were we?
No, man. Just cruising home to Kelowna, and it looks like this on the way. Shame Kelowna doesn't look quite like this, but yeah, this is amazing.
Arriving in Kelowna, I went to stay with Ray and Wanda, who I met on the Inca Trail in Peru. They've recently moved from Toronto and have managed to sort themselves out with an all right little place.
So cool.
And thanks to their hospitality, I was well rested for my long drive to Jasper tomorrow, which I'll be doing by myself, as this is the end of the road for Simon.
I feel like me and Colin have been quite lucky. I mean, you probably watched this and think, no bad rainy days, yeah. Met awesome people, had a blast. Yeah, you could say we are.
I'm actually looking forward to the drive to Jasper because it'll be probably the longest drive I've ever done by myself, but I've got a playlist sorted. I'm gonna be cranking it out.
On that note, goodbye. It's been a pleasure hanging out with you guys.
Nice.
Just driving around the corner, getting close to Jasper, and then I saw this, Mount Robson, highest peak in the Canadian Rockies. Literally came around the corner and was like, holy shit, it's amazing. Okay, so it's the first morning here in Jasper, and the town's just down there, but what I'm gonna try and do today is walk up to Whistler's summit, which is up there. Now, there's two things I gotta be careful for. One, there's still some snow up there, but I don't think it's gonna be too deep. It should be fine. The guide hostel said it should be fine.
The other thing I've got to watch out for is bears, of course, because there's going to be tons of bears in the woods.
Might just be walking in the mountains alone by myself.
And then get eaten by a bear, and then the travel documentary never gets made.
Well, no, someone finds the footage, and then it'll be a found footage film.
You'll be identified from this video, Carl.
Yeah, it'll be a found footage film.
This will be at your funeral as the last kind of...
It'll be one of those like found footage films that somehow gets edited.
Bears are a bit like most other animals in the wild. If you don't startle them, they'll be fine. But if you just suddenly come around a corner and they see you, they might get startled, and that's when you get in trouble. You're supposed to stay at least 100 meters away from them.
Not gonna lie, I am looking forward to being clear of the trees, because just keep winding around, the only person on the path. And it's still early, so there could be bears about.
What they advise you to do is, if you're walking in a group, is talk really loud, make lots of noise whilst you're chatting to each other, and the bears can hear you coming and they won't be startled. But I'm walking by myself.
Just keep making noise, clapping my hands, which I can't do right now because I'm holding the camera.
Hopefully, none of them will get startled and they won't get eaten, which put a bit of a down on the trip.
Yeah, sure you get it on camera so we can watch it at your funeral, yeah?
Yeah. I'll like, bear, hang on a second, let me get the right angle. I'm not gonna lie, I feel like a complete tit shouting out to these bears, but it's far better than the alternative. We have got a lot of shit on the path here. Bad feeling that might be bear shit. Starting to sound a bit like Steve Irwin here. Crikey, got some bear shit. Might be absolutely fucked.
Yeah, the woods are nearly cleared. I basically want to get beyond this little tree line here, but right now, path is going down a bit and carrying on round.
Stay on the trail. Where's the fucking trail? The trees are definitely getting thinner now, and there's a lot more snow on the path. Don't want a repeat of Ben Lomond's peak in New Zealand where I had to turn around because of the snow. Defeated by the mountain. Got it. Hopefully this shouldn't be so bad. Path is definitely getting worse. To see how it continues. Luckily someone else has already done it. 5 more minutes, I might have to turn back because it's beyond knee deep. There's the knee, there's the snow. Well, gonna have to go back. Footprints have run out, which I've been following. Fallen over a couple of times. Well, it's fucking annoying because I have to go all the way back down through the woods. And it's one of the things, it might be alright if I kept going, I might be okay, but I'm by myself. And that's where it's not worth taking the risk. If I was with a mate, we could just keep going, look after ourselves. Should be fine, but if I'm by myself and I twist my ankle in this deep snow, I'm completely fucked. So there are warning signs at the start saying, you know, don't do this walk because of the snow. So it's my own fault really, but I have to be boring and sensible, go back down. I'm at least 2/3 of the way up as well, maybe even 3/4, but so it's annoying to go back down, back to the woods. Maybe I'll try and get the cable car up and just cheat. But yeah, gutted to be defeated by the mountain once again.
I made it back down to the car without encountering any bears, and I did wonder to myself whether all that worrying about them was a bit unnecessary.
Just leaving the car park, there's a bear right there. Drive past it slowly. You alright, mate? See, the dumb thing for me to do right there would have to get out the car, which a lot of tourists do, and that's when accidents happen. You've got to stay in your car and keep your distance. Saying all that, got pretty close. But yeah, right by the car park. God, if I saw that at the start of the walk, considering how much I was shitting it about bears, fuck. So, goes to show I wasn't wrong, I guess, about worrying about all the bears.
It was just a quick 5-minute drive to the cable car station, where I'd finally make it to the top of the mountain for the spectacular views.
Cost $37 to get the cable car up. Fuck that. Right, just caught up with Brian, who I met in Bali, right here. He's just come over from Edmonton for the night, and we're going to check out Maligne Lake right now. But yeah, Brian has my favourite line from the entire HK to NY series, which we're definitely bringing it up. I'm going to cut to it right now.
I'm fucking doing peachy. We just need to find peachy now.
But yeah, so we're going to head to Maligne Lake, check it out, and obviously Brian's going to try and find some peachy. It should be good fun.
Looking forward to it, mate.
Absolutely.
That's
deadly view down there.
Just enjoying Brian's tour of Canada.
We went down the wrong road for like an hour? 80k or something.
So we've been going in the wrong direction for an hour, so we've got to go back to Jasper and down another road. Now, where we need to be is on the other side of those mountains. So we did discuss trying to just drive over it, but I don't know if Lola's built for it actually. But
that's all right, we're having fun. It's all part of the adventure.
Yeah. You got to see this road that you're going to be driving tomorrow.
So yeah, I'm driving this road tomorrow, so I get to scope it out. And so yeah, that's good.
Scenic route.
Yeah.
Right, after a 2-hour detour, the first stop of the tour on the Maligne Canyon.
5 minutes away from where we started.
Fucking long way down. Yeah. 3 hours after we started our journey,
we found the lake.
We're doing good. Brian's learned from the master.
You're like a tit doing this.
Made it, brother.
Got you. Quite a little beach treat going on.
Nope.
Sure.
Trust me, the other one was good. Trust me. Amazing. I suck at skimming rocks. I think James would certainly attest to that, and now Brian will. Absolutely. Brian's like, you just got to roll off your finger. So I rolled off my finger and sliced my hand out.
I said I sucked at skimming, but fucking hell.
I'll live, but thanks. Thanks.
Just in case, what's your blood type?
Atta boy. Big bounce on the first one, anyway.
After a couple of messy nights with Brian, I was back on the road and heading down to Banff, the penultimate stop of my trip.
It should take a few hours, so I'm going to be stopping along the way at different waterfalls, different lakes, and glacier. It's going to be great. I mean, the weather's beautiful, it's nice, easy driving. Should get to Banff this evening, and then a couple days later, I get to meet my brother and finally see my niece, which will be great.
You kind of get spoiled with these waterfalls, just like one after another, just unbelievably amazing. This is what I'm driving through, driving up here, come along, and then, oh, massive waterfall. Right, this is getting ridiculous now. Now, one of the most popular tourist attractions around here is the Kelowna ice fields, where you can get on this big bus with these massive wheels and it drives you onto the glacier and you get to walk around, and it's pretty good fun, but it's quite pricey. But what you can actually do is just after the center where you buy your tickets, there's a small road that comes right down by the glacier. You can just walk up yourself for free. About 100 years ago, the glacier went all the way back to the center over there, right by the main road. Now, it starts here. I stopped to film the waterfall and there's a freaking bear over there. Yeah, I thought all these cars were stopped to get a shot of the waterfall like myself, and I get out and there's a bear right there. Good I didn't just jump out right by it. This is without doubt the most incredible road I've ever driven on. I mean, I've been down this way when I was a kid, but I forgot just how spectacular it is. It's just breathtaking.
After a long but fantastic day of driving, I made it to Banff and checked myself into Same Some Backpackers, which was a lovely and quiet, laid-back hostel.
Go! Go! Go!
There was a pub quiz going on in the bar, and our team actually won.
With 36 points, we've got equals MC Hammer. Go!
Our prize was $50 worth of free shots, which meant the next day was a complete write-off. And on top of this, the weather took a turn for the worse.
Well, I've been incredibly lucky with the weather on this trip, considering I'm travelling in spring, not summer, but looks as though my luck has just run out because I'm at Lake Louise and the whole thing's just covered in cloud. I tried to come here yesterday for a full day, but the weather was just as shit, plus yesterday I was feeling like shit too, but it's my last morning in the Rockies, so I thought at least I've got to pop along and see Lake Louise. Now, there's lots to do here, lots of really cool trails. There's one like round the back of the lake to some glaciers, there's a great hike up to the Beehive. You can get a canoe out on the lake or just chill and enjoy the view, but since the weather's terrible, I'm just going to have a little stroll around and then pop up to Maligne Lake as well.
Maligne Lake looked as if half of it had dried up compared to when I was last here in 2001.
This afternoon I'm going to meet up with my brother and get to see my niece for the first time in a year. So that's, for me, is going to be the climax of the trip.
Today I've met up with this guy. This is the person, the thing, the reason I'm doing this whole trip. And seeing Rob now, like, of all the things like I've done, all the lakes, the mountains, the beautiful scenery, the wildlife, the friends I met up, when I see Rob's face, I realise it wasn't worth it. So thanks a bunch. Yeah. But there you go, you still have to make do in life.
We're finishing up in Calgary. The climax of my trip was obviously getting to see my niece again. She's now 2 years old, she's changed so much, but I'm obviously not gonna put my 2-year-old niece on my YouTube channel, but still, it's amazing spending all that time with my brother as well and Joanna. I mean, they're the whole reason I did this trip in the first place. When I arrived in Calgary though, I was just exhausted. I mean, the whole 2 week trip, I just packed it full of so much. Every day going somewhere new, so doing something different. Out drinking pretty much every night, and so I was just done. Obviously the HK to NY trip, that's 9 months, but we'd have chill out days amongst it. But this was just 2 full-on weeks of just packing it full of so much stuff. It was exactly what I wanted. I wanted to have this great little Canadian adventure, and I cannot recommend going to Canada enough. But as always, what really makes a trip special is the people, and obviously I had the week with Simon at the start and we just had such a good blast together.
Most of my life I've spent in front of a computer. I've just changed it up, mixed it up, left the laptop at home and experienced Canada. I'll be coming back to all these places many times again. I plan on living in Canada for the rest of my life.
Then get stayed with Ray and Wanda, hanging out with Brian, and even in Calgary I got to meet up briefly with Pete, who I met in Nicaragua. And of course there's all the new people we met along the way as well, and that's the amazing thing about travelling, is you can spend just one day with these people and just feel like best friends. It sounds kind of corny, but it's true.
Birthday.
And now I've got 2 months back at home in London before I do my next trip, where I'm going to be travelling with James again to Panama, Colombia and Venezuela for 7 weeks. And it's just going to be freaking epic. I mean, I can't wait to be travelling with James again. It's going to be such a good laugh. The places we're going to are incredible, so it's, yeah, definitely something to look forward to.